I think it's only fair that I don't take the heat for what you said, Jesse, and I'm not trying to be, but I'm getting people attacking my character now for having had to take the show down because you made two allusions to killing people. So I'm not trying to be a right now, but like I've got 500 messages of like, what are you doing? Why are you taking the show down? Are you with us? You're trying to make money.
So I thought YouTube took the show down.
No, I had to take the show down. Okay. I had to take the show down because you made two allusions within like the span of a couple minutes to murdering people.
Who is that man and what has he done with Tim Pool? That was incredible and honestly not expected at all. But nonetheless, you just watched Tim Pool basically tell his guest, a guy named Jesse Kelly, to basically tone down his violent rhetoric. But as Pool is about to explain, this isn't a new problem. It's apparently one that he ends up dealing with quite often. So let's watch more of this interaction and then I'll fill you in on the details as we know them. Let's watch.
After I explicitly stated in the pre-show, do not make allusions to violence, okay, then went on to explain, we keep having people come here and saying they want people killed or people should kill people or they can be killed or things like that.
Tim, yes, yes, thank you. Look, this is all I want from Tim Pool, right? And by the way, anyone on, he doesn't think he's right wing, whatever, fine. I'll take that at face value, even though he says things that are kind of right wing sometimes. Any show, any independent outlet, like please stop egging on civil war. Please stop egging on violence. We need to find a way to tone things down a little bit. People are gonna disagree politically for sure, but we shouldn't be barreling toward violence where Americans literally fight one another. That would be a disaster. And so that like very strong response to Jesse Kelly is kind of incredible. And I'll get into what he allegedly said in just a moment, but Cenk, jump.
Yeah, yeah, okay. So half credit at most. So he explains and he's right about this. He's like, look, if you say you want to kill specific people, that is illegal. So if we put it up on a platform, including Rumble, which is very right wing, they're gonna make us take it down. There's no question about it, okay? Because we can't, they cannot allow illegal things on their platform. So don't do that because it makes me take down the show and my audience yells at me and they come up with conspiracy theories. Gee, huh, a right winger's coming up with conspiracy theories on why you took it down. So shocking. And what does that do? That costs them money.
Good.
And he doesn't want to lose the money.
Good.
And I'm not blaming him. I'm not, that makes sense. Well, you can't do, if you have to take down every show you ever did, you can't forget making money. You can't exist as a show, right? So yes, I'll give him the half credit that Anna's giving him. He's pulling that back, and I don't even like. I'm not even taking away too much credit because he's doing it because otherwise there is no show, right? But I'm not giving him any credit on violence overall. I mean, look at his background. There's the sword and the gun. I've been at his compound and it's complicated, and so I'll give you the nuance, but there's guns everywhere. Every wall has tons of weaponry, right? And Tim makes reference to the Civil War hundreds of times.
Okay, so we'll get to that in a moment. But look, we live in America, and whether you like it or not, people love guns. People see guns as like something that they engage in for a hobby. So like simply having guns in your background, I don't think is advocating for violence. Others might disagree and that's your right to disagree.
I know, but Anna, hold on. So if I said he has guns in the background, hence he's definitely in favor of violence, you could make the point that you're making. But for him to be horrified that there might be a reference to a shooting when the whole place is built. I mean, like I walked out of there thinking, and they were good to me. And like, so there's the nuance. Like, it was a good conversation. I massively disagree with him on his right-wing points. We actually agreed that on corruption and how much it sucks and how much the establishment sucks on that front. So I'm not giving you a black and white view, and I'm glad they invited me. It was interesting, and we had, yes, and we had a little bit of sushi together and all of that, right?
Oh, look at you.
Oh my God.
Hobnobbing with Tim Pool.
Yeah. Mm-mm-mm. So look, guys, I'm giving you the full picture, but at the same time to say like, oh, I can't believe anybody who was for shooting people. There's guns everywhere.
Okay.
Yeah, at some point somebody, and when everybody on the right uses talking points of, oh, you gotta stand up to the tyranny of government. And what do you think happens when you stand up to the tyranny of government? How do you do that? And you say, you need my guns. Well, what are you gonna do with a gun? You're not gonna shoot flowers out of it, you're gonna shoot bullets out of it. And by the way, if they could, would they say to kill specific people? Well, they do it even when they're not allowed to.
Okay, but look, let's just get to the next video because I think it's important to understand what Jesse Kelly allegedly said. The conversation took place last Friday and Tim Pool has edited out whatever it is that he said that was objectionable. So we don't know for sure what he said, but in the next clip, Tim Pool apparently describes what Jesse Kelly had said.
18 minutes into the show, you had made two allusions to, one was the helicopter thrown over the Pacific Ocean. That's kind of like a, we're gonna get hit for that probably, but you know, we'll see what happens. But then you said you can go kill the human smugglers for all I care. And it's
so I'm guessing that they were talking about immigration when the questionable remarks were made by Jesse Kelly. Look, the other thing that I don't think you're giving him enough credit on, and look, people are gonna get mad at me for giving Tim Pool too much credit. Go ahead, get mad at me. You can at me as much as you want. He is making this statement to Jesse Kelly's face on his show. He didn't pull him aside and have like a quiet talk with him. He wanted to make a statement and he made a statement in a very public way. So it wasn't just a statement to Jesse Kelly, it was kind of a statement to anyone else who comes on his show and advocates for violence.
It's again, at best half credit. And I'll tell you why, because but Anna, hold on.
Okay.
So because he said right there, my fans are yelling at me and I want to clarify, it's not me, it's him. So yeah, he's saying it publicly because otherwise his fans are gonna have conspiracy theories about how he's now working with Mr. Google and has married Mrs. YouTube. And that's when they took it down together, when they otherwise they would have had a nice orgiastic violence fest and it's all Tim's fault. So he's saying it's not my fault, it's that guy's fault and it's the platform's fault. So that's why he's saying it publicly. And I would argue, and again, I've agreed with Tim Pool on some things and I'm open to those conversations, but on the issue of violence, I think is, you know, Anna's gonna show you the tweets here. I think what Tim's being saying is be more subtle. Like, don't say you're gonna kill specific people because that's illegal. Say, oh, wouldn't it be amazing or terrible if we all killed each other like in a giant civil war?
Yeah, so he does tweet and talk about civil war quite a bit. So here is a collection of tweets from Tim Pool. I don't even think this is all of them, where he mentions civil war. Some of these tweets are worse than others. Let me give you a few examples. Let's put this up. Let's put this graphic up. So it's hard to read on the screen, but I'll read a few of them for you. The very last one says, yep, that's it, civil war. They refuse to back down. They are actually insane. There's a lot of like, oh, they did something bad to our preferred politicians, namely Donald Trump, and as a result, civil war. This is inching us closer to civil war.
Come on, Tim, you're telling me that doesn't egg people on to do something about it violently?
I just want him to stop with that, okay? If this is a new day in America and Tim Pool has decided, okay, I gotta tone down my rhetoric because this is actually encouraging people, then great,
Yes.
All of us make mistakes, especially in media. And then we realize, okay, my rhetoric needs to be toned down a little bit because it's actually hurting more than it's helping. If he's in that phase of his life, I'm all for it. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah, so look, there's a giant difference. And that's why I appreciated the one that Anna read. When you say, and as we've said on the show, hey guys, this is getting crazy. Look at this poll, 41% of Republicans believe that we should resort to violence. But look, over like around 30% of Democrats think the same thing. And then we say, look, that I'm worried about a civil war, don't do that. As opposed to, yep, that's it, civil war, they refuse to back down. That's saying you should do civil war. You could pretend that you're not saying that, but that's what that sounds like.
It's at least a justification for civil war,
yeah,
right?
And the left is talking about civil war in terms of, oh God, I hope that doesn't happen, that's crazy, right? The right is talking about it like, whoo, can't wait, right? When they have all those guns, they gotta use it for something. Keep it real, keep it real. You could all pretend to be peaceniks and that you've never thought of shooting anyone on the right. Wink, sure.
Thanks for watching the video, guys. We also love it if you hit the join button below because that makes you a member, and members allow us to be independent, honest. We could be as progressive as we want, no corporate media influence, and that's all because of you guys. We love doing the show with our members. Hit the join button, become one of the Young Turks.